Hi there.
In this video, we'll be talking about creating a wall calendar in InDesign. So let's get started. I'm going to change the units to inches and then enter the dimensions 10 by 20 inches. So it's going to be a tall document because half of it will be occupied by the image like in wall calendars. And the rest will be the actual calendar. I'm going to let the page be one. And the margins are already set to 0.3937 inch, which I'm fine with. The bleed is already set to 0.1181 inch, which is about 3 millimeters. So let's just hit create. Since it's a calendar, all the months would follow the same template. And for that reason, rather than working on a page, I'll work on the A master. So let's select the A master. Let's establish the center of the page, and to do that, let's drop a guide at 10 inches from the ruler above. For the calendar, we'll need a table, so let's go to Table and select Create Table. In the pop-up menu, update the body rows to 5, which can even be set to 6 in certain cases, depending upon where the first of the month will fall. Columns to 7 for 7 days of the week, and the header rows to 1 for the days. And hit OK. Now, leaving some space for the month's name, click and drag to create the table as illustrated. Let me zoom in. Since the first row is the header row, and we don't want the header row to be as big as the rest of the rows, so let's reduce the height of the header by clicking inside the first row, and then dragging the top edge of the second row to the top as illustrated. Let's type in the days in the header. Select the days and then center align them, both horizontally and vertically. Now let's change the font to Stardust Adventure. Let's also increase the font size to 30 points. Let's go to Window and then Styles and select Table Styles. Let's select the header and actually let's switch to the Cell Styles tab and create a new cell style. Double-click the new style and move to Strokes and Fills tab and change the cell fill color to black and tint to 15% and hit OK. Now it's time to add numbers to our calendar, so click the first cell under Sunday and go to Type and then Bulleted Numbered Lists and select Apply Numbers. You'll find nothing happens, but the moment you enter a space, number 1 will be added to the cell. And you could also find a full stop after that. And usually in calendars, you'll not find a full stop after numbers, so let's change that. Let's go to Window and show Properties. You'll find the bullets and numbering option at the bottom. Let's click the Options tab to reveal a pop-up window. Now, next to the number field, you'll find a few characters that look more like junk characters. You'll need to delete the last 3 characters from here, which are full stop, a circumflex, and the letter T. You should be left with only a circumflex and a hash, and then hit OK. Let's zoom in for a better view. Select the first cell that has the number 1 added, and go to Edit, and then select Copy. Next, select the entire table, including the cell that has the number 1, and then go to Edit once again, and select Paste. You'll find InDesign adding the rest of the numbers for you. If you look closely, InDesign has actually added more numbers than required, but don't worry, we'll get rid of those numbers soon enough. Select the entire table once again, excluding the days, and let's change the font to Roboto Black. Also, update the font size to 30 points. I think the text appears to be too bold, so let's select the text once again and change the font style to medium. Also update the font size to 24 points. Let's now select the table and push it down a bit because we have some space at the bottom that can be utilized as we'll have to type in the name of the month on top. Grab the type tool and make a text box in the center before the table and type in January. Center align the text and increase the font size to 48 points. Let's change the font to something stylish, so let's pick Freehand. Time to establish the center of the table to align the month name to it. So drop a guide at the center of the table from the ruler on the left, and then center align the name of the month with the help of the guide. Let's select the month name and the table and drag them down a bit as we still have some extra space at the bottom. Perhaps we need to push the name of the month away from the table a bit so as to vertically center align it between the table and the margin on top. Let's concentrate on the top portion of the table now. Grab the rectangle frame tool and make a rectangle covering the entire top, including the bleed space. Let's go to File and then Place and locate the image on your computer and hit Open. Once the image is up, right-click and go to Fitting and select Fit Content to Frame. Let's now delete those extra days from the calendar. So let's just say the 1st of January falls on Thursday. So instead of removing the dates 32 to 35, I'm going to remove the first 4 days so that the 1st January falls on Thursday. The moment the days are removed, the dates will fall into place as expected. Let's hit W for a preview. I think it's looking decent enough. Let's go to the Pages panel and add another page to add the next month. So I'm going to demonstrate 2 months so that you'd know how to add the rest yourself. Since we've created our design on the A Master, the new page will already have the same design. Now, let's double-click page 2 to update the month of February. I'm sure you know by now how to override the master settings, so if you double-click the month, you'll find it not getting selected, since it's inherited from the A Master. So let's hit Shift and Command on a Mac or Shift and Control on a PC to be able to select the elements on this page. Let's change the name of the month to February. Now to remove just the image and not the frame, press Shift and Escape and then hit the Delete or the Backspace key. And you shall find the image gone with the frame still intact. To insert a fresh image, go to File and then Place and locate the image on the computer and press Open. Once the image is up, right-click the image and go to Fitting and select Fit Content to Frame. Since the month of January ended on a Saturday, the 1st of February should begin on Sunday. Hence, all we need to do is remove the last row. So select it and hit the delete or the backspace key. And job's done. Check the preview of February and then of January. I think it's time to pat your back as you've just learned how to create a wall calendar in InDesign. Likewise, you can keep on adding the rest of the months to complete the year. Alright guys, that brings us to the close of the session and I shall see you in the next one in just a bit. Goodbye.